Welcome to the channel, guys. My name is Will. Today I'm going to show you three different things that will help you be more efficient at leveling. So this is not necessarily a leveling guide. There's tons and tons of videos that say, hey, go out, do town projects. It's going to be the fastest way to level. And that's because it is. They're going to say, you know, pick up these missions that are super easy to complete. Go knock them out, turn them in, do that on a cycle forever. And you'll get a lot of territory standing. You'll get a lot of XP and you'll even get some gold and it'll help you level really efficiently. That is 100% true, and I totally agree. Town projects are the most efficient way to level, but there's a specific way to do town projects to get that you know, unparalleled leveling experience that everyone keeps saying that you get from town projects that you might not be realizing. You might be going, all right, pick up my town projects, run out of town, go knock them out, run back to the board, turn them back in, blah, 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 back and forth forever, and you're going, okay, I'm getting a lot of experience, cool, but this is really convoluted and I'm really taking a long time and I'm spending 80% of my time traveling. And nobody wants to do that. Traveling in New World is by far the most amount of time you spend doing pretty much anything. So I want to show you guys a way to do this much more efficiently, give you a couple of different scenarios where this is really useful, as well as show you a couple of tips and tricks for, you know, gathering your resources and getting those collected up for turning in your projects in different towns. So we'll start out by just saying, let's say, for example, I have these set iron sets or weapon or armor sets, culling quests, things like that I pick up. You'll see under my town projects, I actually have 24 town projects currently. And some of these overlap specifically. So for example, I have kill 20 boar and kill 12 boar. So simply by killing 20 boar, I'm able to complete 32 boars worth of effort because they stack. So let's say if I went to every town, if I went through each of my controlled settlements here, so all five of these zones that are all connected and I fast travel from each one and collect town projects from them, and let's say every single one of them gave me kill 10 rabbits, I can kill 10 rabbits and complete 5 quests for that. So that's what makes town projects really effective that people aren't really talking about. It's taking advantage of these projects throughout these different towns and grouping them up and doing them. And even, for example, ones that have me collecting timber. So I actually have 2 different quests for gather 90 timber. This isn't as simple or as easy as the culling ones where they literally are connected and by doing one, I'm doing another. I still would have to gather 180 timber. But at least I'm in a situation where I know I can go out and farm specifically 180 timber, turn these in, boom, done. And I'm only traveling once to gather timber for multiple projects. Because again, travel time is a big deal in New World. So especially when it comes to ore farming, if I need to get iron ore to make ingots or something like that, going out, gathering iron ore, coming back in, making ingots, turning those in is very time consuming. But if you have 3 different projects that have you collecting iron, you can complete 3 projects for roughly the same amount of time, just by simply gathering a little extra ore while you're out and about. So that's what makes completing town projects super duper efficient, guys. Grouping up your projects from different towns, taking advantage of your low Azoth costs you have traveling amongst your different settlements that you control. For example, I can travel all the way from the top of Brightwood all the way down to the bottom of First Light for 40 Azoth. So you can see I don't have a lot of Azoth right now because I was actually grinding this pretty heavily recently. And that's part of the reason why I realized it was so incredibly efficient, because I was just simply doing it. And I haven't been doing a lot of quests. You can see I have 1,000 quests picked up that I've been turning in. You get Azoth as quest rewards. It's also really smart to take advantage of the tools. So Azoth extraction. So I have a 38% chance every time I mine a node of getting an Azoth back. And taking advantage of these, getting a lot of tools that do that can help recoup some of your costs while you're out farming. If I go and hit 20 nodes and I get back 7 or 8 Azoth, that's, you know, a third of a travel right there. And I do that for my gathering, my skinning, all these different things. We'll recoup a lot of your Azoth costs while you're out gathering and getting your resources and making it easier for you to continue to fast travel. Keep in mind, you don't want to burn through all your Azoth. Don't just burn through all your Azoth down to nothing and be like, crap, now I got to gather more Azoth. You always want to have a steady supply of Azoth. A few good ways to farm up Azoth are doing corruption portals. Again, gathering, if you have the gathering tools. And completing missions will give you Azoth as well. So if you're doing that, you go through, you grind out, you get down to a couple hundred Azoth, go out, complete some quests, do that, spend a couple hours, go knocking it out, recoup some Azoth, and then go back out, start grinding again. And then the second thing I want to talk to you guys about, or I guess technically the third thing I want to talk to you guys about, is ways to transfer resources to allow you to complete projects. So for example, I needed coarse leather and iron for a project here in Brightwood. You can actually, on the right side, you can go to other storages and you can pay to transfer items, a small amount of gold. So this is not the most efficient way gold-wise to do it, but it is the fastest way to do it. So I actually simply just I transferred over 25 iron. So you can see it'll cost me 2.37 gold to transfer 25 iron from Everfall to Brightwood, then allowing me to go instantly turn in this quest. I don't normally do it that way. I go through, I collect all the quests, I go to my main hub, I gather all the resources I need, and then I will turn them in town by town is the way I normally do it. Another way that's more affordable and also will help is you can actually go through, list an item for sale. So I could sell these coarse leather, put them for a stupid price. I could put them for example, 100 gold, list them for one day. If I list all of these for, not really 100 gold, let's say they're selling for that. Let's say I'll list them for 2 gold. It only costs me 1.7 gold to list all this coarse leather. And then I can simply travel to another town and then just cancel that order and get that leather back and then trade it in and then turn it in at that town. Keeping in mind that your encumbrance does affect your fast travel costs. So for example, it costs me 26 gold right now to travel to Everfall based on how much I weigh. If I weighed twice as much, it would cost me about twice as much to travel. Not really, it'd cost me another 10 or 12 Azoth. So keeping your encumbrance down while you're fast traveling is super important. So completing those projects, finding out ways, maybe spending a little bit of the gold you get from completing your projects will help you to maintain your Azoth costs by just spending a little bit of gold instead to transfer those items from town to town. And that's really it, guys. That's the entire video. Take advantage of the town projects by going town to town, gathering a ton of projects at once, knocking out as many of them in succession as you can. I will actually go through and I will pin all the rabbit ones. I'll pin all the gather timber ones. I'll pin all those and I'll knock those out in chunks. So I'll go through and do them in chunks. Obviously, if I have multiple projects that can be completed near each other, I'll do those as well. But just for my brain and my organization's sake, I will actually go through and I will group them up. And that's the entire video, guys. So I hope it worked out for you guys. I hope you guys understand the whole idea of people really saying, go do town projects, knock them out. That's the best way to do it. There is more to it. There is a much more efficient way and a much stronger way to do it. You're going to notice incredible. There's no way to compare it. You're going to be 3 to 4 times more efficient doing it this way than just going in and out of town constantly in the same town, completing those projects. This is going to blow your mind how much more efficient it is. Keep in mind, it does require you to start managing your Azoth resources, your gold resources, things like that. It involves you to be a little more involved with those projects, but it's going to be so much more efficient and it'll help you guys level much, much faster. So if you like the video, drop a like, subscribe for more content like this, and I'll be making more videos trying to break down some of these things and make them a little more clear cut and better to understand for people that are new to New World as well as people that are new to just MMOs in general. I'll be breaking down a lot of things to help you understand different concept, different things about MMOs as well as New World specifically to help you have a better understanding of the game. So like and subscribe for more content like this, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.